the least that the Supreme Court could have done was even to stay the investigation till the next day, till the state files a status report, right? It could have waited.
The more important issue is that the Himachal Pradesh police, unlike with many other police departments in this country, are filing FIRs simply on the basis of a complaint. They are not really applying their mind to see if an offense is actually made out, or if the ingredients of the offense that is being alleged are even being made out in the question.
You know, the difference between the Delhi Police FIR as well and the Himachal Pradesh FIR is that in Delhi Police, there was no sedition, okay? And Himachal Pradesh FIR has sedition added as a charge. The least that the Supreme Court could have done was even to stay the investigation till the next date, till the state files a status report, right? It could have waited.
What is interesting about this FIR, and this is very different from other sedition FIRs, is that it seems to draw a link between the spreading of what they call fake news with the raising of sentiments against the existing government with a view to topple it. So what they're essentially saying is that some kind of fake news has been spread by Mr. Vinod Dua, where the intention is that the listeners of that news will be instigated to topple the government as it stands. I find this interesting because it's the first time I've seen an FIR in relation to fake news leading to some other effect besides the fraud in the fake news in itself. And also because there have been a number of very frivolous, seemingly frivolous FIRs relating to sedition that have been filed across the country against a number of people. This one at least seems to attempt to satisfy the ingredients of sedition. And in that in itself, it's a further progress than ones that we have seen in the past.
The more important issue is that the Himachal Pradesh police, unlike with many other police departments in this country, are filing FIRs simply on the basis of a complaint. They are not really applying their mind to see if an offense is actually made out, or if the ingredients of the offense that is being alleged are even being made out in the question. The problem underlying all of this is that there are no consequences against the police for having done something like this. That simply not applying their mind, the FIR may be struck down, but it is a breach of an individual's important constitutionally protected civil liberties that they are put to harassment under the procedure simply because a police officer could not be bothered to apply his mind to whether an offense was actually made out. So what the Supreme Court order really does is to sort of, one, of course, give the protection to Vinod Dua. But second, it doesn't yet, and maybe this is our prime opportunity for the court to go into, it doesn't yet create any sort of responsibility on the police officer for having filed a frivolous FIR in a case where clearly no such offense is made out.
Now, in this instance, the Honorable Supreme Court also in Arnab Goswami's case had said that there must be also a balance between the need to investigate an FIR and the need for the law to protect journalists' freedom in the ambit of Article 19(1)(a) of the Constitution of India. It is good to recall Mr. Salve's pleas in that case that FIRs had been launched to stifle the free expressions of views by an independent journalist. So these will be considered in July when the hearing is scheduled for, if all the pleadings have been completed. So we must look out upon it in that context. Of course, the interim protection given to Mr. Dua was different than the one given to Mr. Goswami. In essence, there one FIR was allowed to continue and the others had been stayed. Here, the FIR in question, the investigation has been allowed to continue, but his arrest has been stayed and he's been given the further concession of being interviewed in his home or by video conference.
The difference between those two is Arnab's FIR was, it was under the provisions for invoking communal disharmony, because he had, you know, blamed a particular community. He had named the community in his show and he had provoked communalism by naming that community. So that's the difference. In Vinod Dua's case, he's only talked against the government and how the government was busy preparing, you know, for the foreign delegation or foreign visitors or visits, instead of, you know, just actually taking care of COVID or the migrant workers.
The first thing to note is that the court's order is largely based on the concession made by the petitioner himself, Mr. Vinod Dua, saying that he is ready and willing to participate in any investigation, provided it is done from the comfort of his home and that he is not asked to visit the police station. There is a difference to be noted here that he is a senior citizen suffering from certain ailments, and as per the government's own directives, the Himachal Pradesh police should not have asked him to come to the police station at all. To that extent, the court has only affirmed what he had requested the police, which is that they should, if any questions are to be asked about the FIR, approach him at home.
And the order that the Supreme Court has passed is that he cannot be arrested. So as far as the arrest is concerned, he's protected. But yet, he has to, you know, cooperate and he has to join investigation, because that was also the concession given by Vinod Dua himself. He said that he cannot travel. You know, he gave COVID as the reason. So now what the Supreme Court has said is that, okay, you go to his residence and, you know, follow social distancing and the other norms and you join investigation.